Welcome back to HM Learnings. This is the video in the series of apoptosis, and today we will talk about the mechanism of apoptosis. Firstly, we will talk about the caspases, then we talk about the general layout of mechanism of apoptosis, a detail of the extrinsic mechanism, and lastly its regulation. So we know that apoptosis is triggered by the activation of the intracellular proteases called as the caspases. Now, this caspase will cause a degradation of the multiple nuclear and the cytoplasmic protein to finally cause the death of the cell. This caspase in a normal cell is present in the inactive form called as a procaspase. So it is an inactive form in the normal cell. So on the arrival of a death signal, the procaspase will be converted into the caspase and it will cause the death of the cell. So from this you can say that caspases have a central role in the apoptosis. So now it becomes important for us to understand the caspases. Now talking about the caspase, we can write it as, so we know if a term ends with a suffix of ase, it shows that it is an enzyme. The C stands for as there are cysteine residues at the active site of the enzyme. The S stands for the, as this caspase target the protein at the specific aspartic residues. So it will target the protein and cleave it at the specific aspartic residues. Moreover, the caspases are basically divided into the two classes. The one class is called as the initiator caspase, and the another class is called as the executioner caspase. So when a death signal came, it causes the activation of the initiator caspase. And the initiator caspase has only one function, that is cause the activation of the executioner caspase, which will finally cause the death of the cell. Now this is a slide which shows all the points which I have already explained. You can pause the video and write it down. Now we'll talk about the general layout of the mechanism of apoptosis. So this is, I have already explained you that the procaspase will come and a death signal will actually cause the conversion of a procaspase into a first class of the caspases called as the initiator caspase. This initiator caspase will then further cause the activation of the executioner caspases, and this will degrade the proteins which will lead to the death of the cell. Now this death signal can cause the activation of the initiator caspase either by the extrinsic pathway or by the intrinsic pathway. So you can say that there are two pathways of the apoptosis. Number one is the extrinsic pathway and number two is the intrinsic pathway. Although these two pathways are actually entirely different from each other, as they consist of a different sets of the proteins and different events, but their end result is the same, that is both this pathway will cause the activation of the initiator caspase. From here, the pathway will be common in both these pathways. Now this is a slide which shows you the fill in the blanks and the two mechanism, extrinsic pathway and the intrinsic pathway. So it shows that finally both the pathways get the conversion of a initiator caspase into an executioner caspase called as caspase 3. So when we end both these pathways in our video, you can write the answers in the comment section and we will discuss the answers of this fill in the blanks also. This mechanism is also called as a death receptor pathway. So the extrinsic mechanism is called as the extrinsic mechanism because it is mediated by the death receptor, and this death receptor is located on the cell membrane or the cell surface. Secondly, it is called as a death receptor pathway because the whole thing is actually depends upon the expression of the death receptor on the cell surface. The death receptor and the death ligand, which binds to the death receptor, both these are actually the members of the tuber necrosis factor receptor superfamily. So, whenever a cell decides to undergo the process of apoptosis by the extrinsic mechanism, it starts expressing that death receptor on its cell membrane, which is actually a signal for the death ligand to bind to it and trigger the process of apoptosis. So, what are the steps in the extrinsic mechanism? And this will we see in the next slide. So, here you can see this is actually a cut of a diagram which I have taken from the molecular biology of by the Alexander. So here you can see this is a fast ligand which is expressed on a killer lymphocyte. So this fast ligand will go and bind to the cell, the target cell, which is now expressing the fast death receptor. So this fast ligand and fast death receptor both are the members of the TNF receptor superfamily. So before that, we should know about the death receptor, that what is this fast death receptor is. So this is a cell membrane, and to this cell membrane we have a fast death receptor. So this is a fast death receptor as shown in the figure. So by this you can say that this fast death receptor is which type of receptor? It is a transmembrane receptor. Means what? Means it spans through the membrane. It passes through the cell membrane, and that is why it is called as a transmembrane receptor. Now this transmembrane receptor has three domains. The one domain which is lying outside the cell called as the This part is called as the extracellular domain. And this extracellular domain has a side for the binding of a ligand. So the ligand will come and bind to it. So it has a ligand binding site. The next domain is passing through the membrane or lies in the membrane, and is called as the transmembrane domain. And the third domain, which is on the inner side of the cell, is called as the intracellular domain, or the another term which is used is the cytoplasmic domain, because it is in the cytoplasm. And the another term which is used for this domain is the death domain. So you will be surprised why the term death domain is used here. So because this domain, this dark red in color domain, which is the cytoplasmic domain of the fast death receptor, is involved in the interaction with the various proteins which are responsible for the death of the cell. So that is why this part, this domain, is also called as a death domain. So this death domain has a function that it allows the binding of the various types of the proteins which are involved in the death of the cell. So this death domain processes the charges on its outer side, and through the help of these charges, the death domain will attach to the another death domain by the means of electrophobic interaction, and hence the multiple protein will interact with each other. So now we will look at the steps. The first step is that the fast ligand will go and bind to the fast death receptor. So the fast ligand will go and bind to the fast death receptor. So we know that the fast death receptor has a cytoplasmic domain shown here in the dark red color. So now this cytoplasmic domain of the multiple fast death receptor will come close to each other, and this cytoplasmic domain, also called as the death domain, will form a binding site for another protein known as adapter protein. So the cytoplasmic domain, here you can see in the diagram, they will form a binding site for the another protein called as the adapter protein. So this is an adapter protein. Again, this adapter protein, if you can see here, will show one death domain. So this is a death domain of the fast death receptor in a dark red color, and this is again a death domain of the adapter protein, which is in the dark red color. So this two death domain will form the electrophobic interaction between each other and bind to each other. This is called as the, because this will go and bind to the fast death receptor, it is called as the fast associated death domain. FADD. Okay, and to this death domain attaches a adapter protein, which is in this blue color. So this is an adapter protein. So via the help of this death domain, again what is happening, the adapter protein will attach to the fast death receptor. Now the next step is what? The next step is, again with the help of a death domain, again this is again a death domain which is in a light blue color, and this death domain is of the procaspase 8. So now the death domain of the procaspase 8, which is in the light blue color, it will attach to the adapter protein, and it will also attach the caspase, the procaspase 8. So the procaspase 8 will attach to adapter protein via death domain. So now you can understand the importance of a death domain. So the fast death receptor, which is processing a cytoplasmic domain or the death domain, binds to the death domain of the adapter protein, and again with the help of a death domain, the adapter protein attaches to the procaspase 8. So this shows the importance of a death domain. So now what has happened? So finally, these three things. This is a fast ligand. This fast ligand has came. It will bind to the fast receptor. This fast receptor has a death domain through which it will bind to the adapter protein. And this adapter protein then bind to the procaspase 8, again with the help of a death domain. So these three things along with their death domain is called as the death inducing signaling complex or the DISC. It is called as the death inducing signaling complex. So now what does the function of this death inducing signaling complex? Because of the formation of this, the procaspases 8, they will cause an assembly, which will result in the formation of assembly of procaspase 8. So they will come close to each other, and as a result, they will cause the autocleavage of each other, which will lead to their activation. So they will autocleave each other, and hence the procaspase 8 will be converted into its active form, called as the caspase 8. This activated caspase 8, which is an initiated caspase, causes the activation of the executioner caspase. So caspase 8 will cause the activation of the executioner caspase, which is caspase 3. And this caspase 3 will then cause the death of the cell. Moving to the next slide, Here I am summarizing all the points we have covered in the last three slides. Okay, so the first thing is that the death receptor, which is a fast death receptor, bind to the fast ligand. After this, the cytoplasmic domain of the fast receptor forms a binding site for adaptor protein. So the cytoplasmic domain, which is in red color, it comes close and it will form a binding site for the adaptor protein. The adaptor protein will bind to the fast receptor with the help of a fast associated death domain. Fourth step is the adaptor protein will bind to procaspase 8 via death domain, and there will be a formation of a disc, which is a death inducing signaling complex. So this consists of fast receptor, adaptor protein and a procaspase 8. After this, there will be assembly of the multiple procaspases 8, which will be lead to the autocleavage of each other and cause the formation of activated caspase 8, which will finally cause the activation of the executioner caspase, caspase 3. Now, after the activation of caspase 3, there will be apoptosis, which has been completed. So we said that in the last video that apoptosis is genetically regulated, or it is called as a programmed cell death. So if you haven't watched the last video, I have shared the link in the iTip as well as in the description box. You can go and check the video there. So if it is called as the genetically regulated, then the term has to be justified. So we can justify this by looking at these two points, that the gene for the fast ligand is transcriptionally inactive in most cells. So in most of the cells, they can't synthesize the fast ligand because the gene responsible for it remains inactive most of the time. The another protein, which is called as a FLIS-like inhibitory protein or FLIP, is actually a structural analog of caspase 8, and it will bind to the adaptor protein and thus inhibits the apoptosis. So you can understand this by looking at the previous slide. So here in the disc assembly, this is a procaspase 8 which binds here. Now the FLIP protein, which is actually a structural analog of procaspase 8, will not allow the procaspase to bind. Instead of procaspase, the FLIP will bind to it. Now this FLIP doesn't have any enzymatic activity like that of the procaspase 8, and hence the disc is not functional as it is supposed to be. So there will be no activation of the caspase 8 and there will be no activation of the caspase 3. As a result, the apoptosis will be inhibited. Now we will reach at the end of the video. These are the two books you can refer for this topic. In the upcoming video, we will talk about the intrinsic mechanism of apoptosis and the cardiovascular physiology. If you like this video, please like, share and comment, and do subscribe the channel for more videos like this. Till then, keep learning.